Hey guys, welcome back to the channel once again, and in this video I'll show you how can you set up an extra router as a wireless extender or a repeater so you can access internet beyond the range you are allotted with your native router. So the IP address of the router will always be or must be set by default as 0.1 ending with this thing, and the password must be also set by default as admin admin. Okay, so all right, here we have the interface. You can see the first router, which is obviously made by TP-Link, and the second one, which we are going to extend or we are going to use as a repeater, that is made by Tenda. So the interface is also going to be same, not that much different. So I couldn't actually find the title to make a video, so that's why. And this is actually a problem, not a clickbait any kind of thing, that how can you use Tenda router as a repeater with TP-Link router. So this is the native one, and now I think we are connected with the other router. Yes, we are connected. So now if I refresh this page, you can see here we have the thing, the interface of Tenda. So the password is again the same, default admin and admin, so you can log in easily clicking over advanced, and here is the thing. Jumping into the wireless and wireless extender, and here we have to do the thing. But before that, make sure you do a few things, and the thing is you make change under the LAN settings. Like as you know, this router is set as 192.168.0.1, which is same as the first native routers. We are going to change the first thing, the IP address. You can change it to 1.1 or anything you would like. Make sure this is close to the class, like the same C class IP address. If that's different, that wouldn't be an issue, but just for the name. So just name it 1.1, okay? It's rebooting, then we will go with next step. Okay, so we are logged out and we are going to log in once again. So here we are clicking over advanced. And this time, if you see, it's changed to 192.168.1.1. So now this the second thing that I recommend you to set up the password, and that is here is the thing. Disable the WPS thing, because you don't want any kind of vulnerability for this device. So yeah, giving it a security key. And that's it. Make sure you do these things just before setting up the router as a repeater, because if once you set up it as a router repeater, this is not going to be easier for you to change the password. It must be set as open network and everyone will be able to access your internet, so it's better you change the password right now. Okay, here we are. So we're just going to connect it now. And the password was this. Okay, we are close to get into this. All right, we are connected with the router, so we are just going to refresh the page so we can have the things we want to look at. Okay, all right, so we are jumping into the wireless section, going to the wireless extender, and just going to change it to WISP. There are several other options with the things, with different things, but this is the best one. You can also set it up as WDS bridge, but this one is better. Okay, so now click over open scan. Make sure the router which you are trying to access the SSID or the Wi-Fi range is close to the router, so you can have a better speed range, speed, durability, and everything. If it is close to the router, it would be better. So you can see here we are going to connect with this thing, and you need to enter the password of the router, the native router. Okay, so we are just going to hit OK. Now it is going to reboot, and that's all we have to do. And after this, we will connect with the same, and we will be able to access the interface of the native router and this router, and as well as we can access the internet, which is coming through wirelessly through the first router. All right, so here we are. So you can see we are connected to this Tenda_35D6E0 with the same thing. And here is the thing. So if I try to access something, here you go. Here we have the internet access working fine. Everything is fine. And as well as if you try to access the first native router, you can have the access with that thing too. Okay, so here we have the TP-Link. If you want to set up, if you want to change something, if you want to access, you can access setup from here, as well as you can make changes with the thing with the second router. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If it was helpful, like, share and subscribe to the channel. And I made this video specially because I'm going to publish a new video very soon, so that would contain a solution. But this is the thing that I had to show, and this is going to be a solution for that video. So yeah, that's pretty much it for this video. If you still have any questions to ask, you can ask me down in the comment section below. And as always, thanks for watching. I'll see you guys in the next video. Have a great day. Bye bye.